been around for a very long time, but we're seeing them more prevalently these days because they're driven by more collaboration and more collaboration tools and more agile teams and agile methodologies. So it allows for more innovative ways of working together. It increases more autonomy with the teams. It also fosters innovative practices, more so than the traditional top-down structure. So here's some of the common questions that people have when they go to lead. So how do you lead them if you're the head of the organization? And also, what role do managers and executives play in this setup? And how do you measure their success? So one thing to avoid is to try to manage or impose external processes on a self-directed or self-managed team is really self-defeating because they are self-managed. They do work in an organization, so they still have to comply with the organization and those organizational structures. So how to lead a self-managed team? Number one, use communication and feedback to foster buy-in. The more you communicate and collaborate and ask them for their opinions and let them contribute, then the more they buy in. And today, there are better software tools that allow for communication and real-time collaboration. Number two, have the team define their metrics of success. If they define their metrics, then they tend to be more accountable for their success. And again, today with the tools, they can set those up and have insights to those in a real-time basis. Number three, have them present their outcomes regularly, promoting feedback loops with other teams they have to interact with, and track some metrics of accountability. And number four, leverage their successes for the good of the business. So here's some things to watch for. Number one, team initiatives that don't align with the corporate strategy. So if you do find the team is working on those, just work with them to reprioritize that they're working on the ones that do. Number two, lack of accountability from the entire team. So if you have an entire team that for some reason doesn't feel accountable for their work products or things that they've committed to, I would look a little deeper because maybe there's a lack of clarity around the roles and responsibilities of who is accountable. Number three, a culture of no results. So if you're looking at a culture, that's pretty deep. That's the behaviors and characteristics of that group. So either you can work with them or bring someone in, or they can work together to reset the culture of that group. Because if you do have one that is yielding no results, those typically get disbanded. Number four, immunity from the rest of the corporate structure or organization. Because many of these self-managed teams are part of special projects, then they may be working in a different building, they may be working virtually, so this is just something to keep an eye on. But these are some of the common questions, these are some ways to lead, and then these are some things to watch for. So if you need a tool that can help you lead your self-managed teams, then sign up for our software.